96. We are Chattanooga's number one hit music station. My name is Gino D, and I'd like to welcome via Zoom a good friend of ours now, Troye Sivan. Troye, welcome.
Hello. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Thank you so much for taking some time and talking with me here. Angel Baby, we'll get right into it. It's the brand new single. The song is absolutely phenomenal. It's so good. And a lot of your music, your fans will know, a lot of your music focuses on love, heartbreak. This definitely fits into that wheelhouse. But even though it's a new song, there's something about this one that sounds familiar. You've definitely taken some cues from the past, I guess we can say, when it comes to this one. In fact, you said yourself that you wanted to bring back the power of ballad. So let's talk about that a little bit. Where was the inspiration for the sound of Angel Baby, the writing process, and how did it all come to be?
Yeah, so for me, I think like this chorus, you know how sometimes you'll hear a song and you're like, surely this chorus exists in the universe somewhere. Like it feels like I've always had it for some reason. Do you know what I mean? Like it just feels very familiar, like you said. And I love that. I mean, I think when you stumble upon something that that has that feeling, but it's like something new and fresh, that's always a really, really exciting thing as a songwriter, I think. And yeah, I mean, it's basically a fantasy. It's like, you know, I start the song off really kind of like broken, I guess, and questioning like, oh, you know, does love even exist? And like, you know, is it something that I'll ever find? And then it's like very dramatic. And it's like, oh, you came out the blue on a rainy night. And it's like this whole, you know, rom-com fantasy. And I just loved it. And so, yeah, we put it out.
Yeah, it has that way about it. You're listening to the song and you start thinking, have I heard this before? It just has that real familiar feeling, almost like you're at home. It's a great song. Is this something, this kind of vibe, this kind of sound, is this something that you're looking forward to in your future songs? Is this a kind of a vibe that we're going to get for a new album maybe, or is this kind of a one and done type deal?
I mean, for me as a songwriter, like I love to explore. And so I don't really know. I mean, like I definitely had fun doing this. I've always been so inspired by 80s pop and, you know, like beautiful analog synth sounds and big drums and everything. It's like very much, you know, stuff that I enjoy. So I'm sure there will be hints of it in future stuff, but I'm also always trying to push myself to do something new.
Excellent. And I think a part of that is the collaborations. I know there's a lot of writing collaborations when it comes to Angel Baby. We're also playing another giant collaboration that you've done recently with Tate McRae and Regard called You. We still have that very high in our rotation. People love it. And I know that was kind of a COVID baby. I think you've referenced it because you actually never met Tate McRae or Regard when it comes to in-person meetings because of the pandemic. So talk about that collaboration process a little bit and how that went down.
Yeah, so basically I got sent the song by Tate, and Regard and her were both already on it. And so I didn't actually write on the song. I mean, I made some structural changes and stuff like that, but the song already existed. And so for me, I was in Australia, like desperately looking for ways to kind of like stay creative and stay musical and everything. And so I just went into the studio and I was like, the song is so good. Like I loved the song. And so I just was like, don't mess this up. And so I recorded my vocal. And once I was happy with it, I sent it off to them and everyone seemed really excited. And then, yeah, it was the weirdest thing, 'cause like none of us had met. The song was doing really well in America. And I was in Australia. And so Tate and I have met now. We met a couple of weeks ago for the first time, and she's so nice. But it's crazy. We've had this like very special experience together now.
Excellent. When it comes to that, not being able to meet face to face, not being able to, I guess, vibe a little bit. It's different, obviously, online. It's just different with Zoom stuff, and you can connect as much as you can. But there's a different. Do you feel more pressure or less pressure when you're kind of putting your input into a project? Does it change at all? Is it awkward? Does that affect the process at all for you?
No, I think, I mean, it takes a lot of the fun out of it, to be honest. Like I really, really, really love collaborating with people. You know, it's like, that's, I always, you know, I don't play any instruments. So I'm always at least working with one person, you know? And it's cool because you bring stuff out of each other and there's like this, you know, you learn how to communicate verbally, but then you also are communicating without saying a word to each other. You know, it's like, there's nothing better than when you're in the studio with someone and like suddenly everyone's like on their feet and you can feel the energy in the room because you're all excited about something that you've got. And that kind of stuff just doesn't happen from afar. So I much prefer to do the thing in real life. Like I'm really happy that now I can at least travel and be with people in real life. But it's just for me, that's like the whole kind of point of it all.
Excellent. And yes, like you've mentioned, you've worked with numerous artists, producers. Ariana Grande comes to mind. That was a big collaboration you've done. Mark Ronson just recently, Casey Musgraves. Are there any highlights? I mean, I'm sure you all have special moments when you're working, but there's anybody that you've worked with that maybe has kind of stood out from the rest or even maybe surprised you a little bit? Maybe you thought they were this type of person or this type of artist, and then they've surprised you in a good way or bad. But any highlights when it comes to collaborations?
I mean, I think Ariana comes to mind just because like we knew each other before we worked together, but then, I mean, she's like one of the biggest stars in the world. So I was really curious to see what it was going to be like to work with my friend in that capacity. And she's just like the easiest, best person to have around. And like the music video day was so much fun. And yeah, I mean, I think it was just that kind of thing where it's like, if anyone could be tough to work with, it's like someone at that level. But then you meet someone at that level and they're just like so chill and so nice. And it was just like a nice moment, you know? It was really cool.
Excellent. Yeah, it's going to be a good feeling too. And then, I mean, you said with Ariana, you were already friends in that sense, but just to be able to vibe with somebody and to get on a creative level and be on the same page must be a good feeling.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
You've been making music now. It's actually been the better part of a decade, right? About 8 years or so when it comes down to it. If somebody's going to listen to the full Troye Sivan catalog, what differences do you think they'd hear from the very beginning to what you're coming out with now? The evolution, if you will. Any comments on that? Have you listened to your old stuff and thought different things?
I think they just hear a lot more confidence, you know, in either the way I'm singing or the way that I'm writing or the kind of like choices that I'm making and the, you know, directions that I'm trying out. But overall, I think the thing is that the root of why I do what I do has always remained the same. And so it's like about trying to make something that makes people feel something and that feels really honest. And that I hope never goes away, you know? So there's a couple of changes, but there's also, I think, some stuff that stayed the same.
Very good.
One time
you've had quite
I wrote
the busy
a song.
Month, not...
No, I was just gonna say one time I wrote a song and it never came out sadly, but I shouted out Chattanooga in the song.
Oh, look at that. Perfect.
Yeah. It was like, I don't want to lie to you, babe, I'm really messed up in Chattanooga.
There like, we go. I was
like, singing about being drunk at a party in Chattanooga.
Oh, that sounds like us. Perfect.
Yeah, nice.
You've actually had quite the busy month with the MTV VMAs. You did a little bit of a pre-show for them. I know that was a big presentation for you. And that was actually kind of right out of the pandemic. You were under quarantine and then you were able to kind of go to MTV and perform live. And you said it was kind of one of those big experiences for you because of that pandemic. So explain that a little bit, because it kind of touched you more than other performances would because of the time you spent away.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's just like I released an EP during the pandemic from Australia, and it really made me realize how much I enjoy and sort of rely on the real life tactile response to music. You know, I kind of felt like I was just like posting an Instagram or posting a tweet. Like it just came out. I couldn't leave my house. So none of those sort of real life experiences were there. And then I knew that I missed it. But then when I performed in New York and I was like just amongst people again, and I saw people singing the songs that I'd put out, it like choked me up. Like I just was so, it was a moment where I felt like everything that's happened could have been just like a dream. And then once I was doing it again, I was like, no, this is actually like real life. Like this is your job and this is still happening to you. And so, it was a nice moment. It was great.
Yeah, it is. And people can check that out, of course, on YouTube, and it's on your social media channels as well as MTV. So people should really check out those performances. And that leads us to the Met Gala. And then you were part of the Fenty Fashion Show with Rihanna, which I'm sure was just amazing. You actually get to be one of the runway models, which must have been pretty cool. Was fashion part of the plan, Troye, when you first started getting into music and all of this? Was fashion something that always something that you wanted to get into?
I mean, I never really thought I would do like runway stuff or like modeling really, you know, but I've always loved fashion. And I think, yeah, for me, it just really goes hand in hand with everything that I do. You know, it's like, I just feel like, yeah, just having it as an outlet to express yourself and to kind of like layer on, yeah, different sort of like layers of your personality. And you can say so much, you know, with what you're wearing, and it completely changes the way that I feel on a day. And so it's 100% been something that I've always loved.
That's very cool. What about being part of those events? Was it something that, were you surprised by anything, or is it exactly what you thought it would be, especially to be that runway model now, to have that chance to walk down? Was it everything you thought it would be, or were you surprised?
I think the only thing I was surprised by was like how comfortable I felt. And I think that's just because of the nature of what Fenty is all about, is like about celebrating you for exactly, you know, the way that you are. I think if I was at any other fashion show, I'd be like, God, all these boys are so tall. And I'm so skinny and like whatever, you know, just like, and kind of none of that came into my mind on that night, because it was all about just like celebrating everybody, you know.
Very good. And people can check that out. That's on Amazon Prime too, and I'm sure numerous people will. And it's just great. And you do seem very confident in yourself when you're on that stage, feeling yourself, nice. Feeling everybody else there. So it must have been a great vibe.
Totally. Yeah, no, it was great.
And you were talking about a little bit earlier, you talking about different layers when it comes to the music, the fashion, and people, some your fans know, but some people may not, that you actually do a little bit of acting as well. And talk about that a little bit, the balance of maybe trying to do acting, doing music. Are you one of those guys that can kind of jump in and one day you're doing this, the next day you're doing that? Or do you have to kind of focus on one project at a time?
With acting, it's kind of tough, because when you're on set, it like consumes your entire life. You know, you're there for like day in, day out for weeks on end. So it's really, really hard for me to switch gears. Like on my off day, I'm not going to go into the studio. So I guess I do kind of have a hard time like switching gears, but it's weird, because when I'm acting, it feels very much like I'm scratching the same itch as when I'm like songwriting. You know, it's all about accessing emotions and feelings that you might not be feeling in that very moment. You know, it's like sometimes, sure, I'm writing a song and I'm like I cry while I write it, and it's all very happening right there and then. But most of the time, you go into the studio and you're like, damn, how did I feel on that day like 3 weeks ago when this happened? And you've got to kind of like re-access that. And acting is like the same thing. You know, it's like, how can I empathize with this character and what they're going through, even though they're about to call cut and I'm going to go on my lunch break in a second? Like, how do I access all of those emotions? And so it is kind of like a similar muscle to me.
Excellent. And I know that you're working on new music. Do you have any new film projects or acting that are coming up as well?
I do. I can't really, I can't talk about the one thing, but the other thing, I filmed a movie in 2020, actually. We filmed a little bit in the beginning of the year, got shut down, and then we finished the movie in the end of the year. And it's my first lead role in an American movie, and it's hopefully going to come out next year. So we'll see.
Something to look forward to for sure. Excellent. Yeah. All right, Troye, I got one more question for you. Thank you so much again for taking the time and talking about some new music and your new projects. Like I've mentioned before, better part of the decade, you've been releasing new music. You are very active on social media, always trying to reach out to your fans and connect. But is there anything about you that people may not know about you that you want people to know about you? Sometimes it's hard to express an opinion or just something about yourself, maybe personally, that you want people to know that it never doesn't come up in regular conversation for you.
It doesn't come up in regular conversation. I feel like because I do so much on social media, people know pretty much everything that I want them to know.
Yeah.
Maybe I guess the only thing is that like, I would really like to speak more on like anxiety and mental health and stuff, because it's definitely something that I struggle with. And so I'd want to kind of like have more conversations about that and see how I can kind of, you know, be of assistance or anything like that.
Yeah, it's definitely a thing. And I think it's getting more of the spotlight nowadays is that mental health and to make sure that people are mentally healthy as well as physically healthy and ready to go at anything. And with all the new things that are happening, it's definitely something to focus on. So I think that's a good idea as well. Troye, thank you so much for the time. We appreciate it right here on Hits 96. We're going to continue to play all of your music and support you in every which way. People will be able to hear Angel Baby, also you. And we're looking forward to more new stuff from you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you.